In this week's video, I'm going to teach you how to create an obscene amount of content. I'm going to take you through my entire process so that you can implement it for yourself and get to making a lot more content. Let's go. Welcome back to the Superhero Institute. My name is Jeff Gibbard, and today we're going to talk about content. Recently, a bunch of people came up to me and told me something along the lines of, you create a lot of content. How do you possibly do it? One person told me, the amount of content you create is intimidating. Another person said to me, dude, I don't know how you create all of this content. And what's funny about that is I think it's a matter of perspective. I see people who create a tremendous amount more content than me, and I don't know how they do it. And some people will look at me that way. So I thought today what I would do is share some of the systems and processes that I use to be able to create the amount of content that I do each and every week. Now, just to give you a sense of what I do every single week, my baseline is I'm going to create one video for the Superhero Institute, one podcast for Shareable, one blog post on my blog. I'm putting out a newsletter. Inside that newsletter, I promote all three of those pieces of content, as well as share five pieces of content that I found from the web and thought were interesting, and I share that with my audience. I'm also on Facebook, on Twitter, on LinkedIn, and on Instagram basically throughout the week, and that's kind of my baseline. On top of that, sometimes I'll upload slides to SlideShare. I might do an Instagram story or Snapchat stories, but in general, I'm creating some form of content each and every day, and I wanted to share how I do it exactly, and I'm going to break it into four parts. So if you're ready, I'm going to take you down path number one, which is knowing what you need to get started. All right, part one, let's talk about what you need before you even get going. You can't just jump right into creating content. That's silly. If you want to build a scalable content solution, something that is sustainable but also scalable, you need to understand why you're doing it in the first place. This is about getting really clear on your brand, understanding who are you, what are you about, who do you serve, and how do you serve them. In doing these exercises, you're going to need to build out a story about how the work that you do actually serves the people that you're serving. And the recommended exercise I would tell you to do is the story brand exercises from Donald Miller's Building a Story Brand. If you haven't bought the book or listened to it on Audible, I strongly advise that you do it. And you can just go to storybrand.com to learn more about what Donald Miller and his company do and why they do it. But it's a really great exercise where you're able to frame what you do into a narrative arc that allows you to better clarify why it is that you're the right person to guide people along that journey. So I'm going to let you go and work on that yourself, but it's a really great exercise to do at the very beginning. And when you get clear on who you are and who you serve and why you serve them, it becomes a lot easier for you to start creating content week in and week out. As an example, the Superhero Institute is designed for freelancers, small businesses, and entrepreneurs. And I'm trying to provide a cornucopia of different skills that will help them grow and build the kind of businesses that allow them to make an impact on the world. Now, I just came up with that right now on top of my head. I've said it probably 5 or 10 different ways, but it all follows that same sort of an arc where I know that what I'm trying to do is empower you with new skills so that you can conquer whatever it is you're trying to conquer. I don't have the answer to every question, but I do have a number of skills that I can share with you and will make you able to grow your business and better succeed in different areas of life. You need to figure out what is your thing. And once you figure out what that thing is, it becomes a lot easier to move on to steps 2, 3, and 4, which we'll get into right now. All right, part two of the process is also somewhat planning, but it's really more of a series of setup tasks. So I'm gonna call this creating and capturing ideas. If you're going to create content, the worst way that you can do it is sit down on the day you're supposed to create it and say, well, what am I going to talk about today? That doesn't work all that well. You want to be ahead of the curve. So what you always want to do is have a list of different ideas for types of content that you've got packed away and ready to go, and you've been working on over time in advance of the day where you need to actually publish it or release it. I typically have a content calendar with hundreds of ideas that I've been working on, and I have different systems that I use to be able to capture those ideas when I have them so that I don't lose them. And sometimes those are just headlines or different chicken scratch ideas that I'm working on, and in other cases, they are fully formed, fully fleshed out ideas that I just have to put the finishing touches on. So I'm going to tell you about some of the tools that I use that help me to better capture my ideas and then be able to work on them over time. So the first application or tool that I would strongly recommend, and it is only available for iOS, I am sorry about that, Android users and Windows users, is an app called Drafts. You've probably heard me talk about this before. I talked about it in the video on how to create time. Drafts is an amazing app where you can actually dictate live right to your iPad or to your iPhone, and then you can take that copy and immediately put it into something. So when I have an idea, I actually have set up using an application on iOS called Shortcuts, just a one-tap icon on my screen, where when I tap that icon, it launches my Drafts application, and then I'm able to dictate my idea directly into my phone. That's how I'm capturing them. But what's important is that these ideas need to go somewhere. So once I've captured an idea, whether I'm dictating it using an application like Drafts, or whether I use an application like Just Press Record, which is another audio note application that records your voice, but also does its best to transcribe it after the fact. Once I have the raw idea out of my head, you need to put it somewhere where you can then move it through a process where it becomes actual real content. For that, I use Notion. And for you as a Superhero Institute member, you will get access to the template that I use that takes content ideas, moves them into a production schedule, and then moves those into a promotion schedule. That is the exact format that I use. It's a lot better than a spreadsheet. It's a lot better than a Google Doc because what it does is it allows you to action that idea and flesh it out right within that database. So rather than just having, you know, one cell in your spreadsheet where you have the idea and then this big clunky cell right next to it where you type everything out, inside Notion, you're able to have the headline, you're able to put a number of other fields for metadata of where you're going to put it, how you're going to promote it, any of those other things, as well as inside of the actual row in the database, be able to write out and flesh out the entire idea right there. So what I do is, if you're looking at how this process all comes together, let me summarize it. I have a full list of content ideas that I keep inside of Notion. And when I need to capture a new idea, I will use an application like Drafts, or I will use an application like Just Press Record to capture that idea. And I'll take that idea that I've captured and put it into my system inside Notion. So if you've been following along thus far, I know who I'm talking to. I know why I'm talking to them from the exercises I did in step one. I know what I'm all about. I know essentially what the focus is of the content that I want to create. And then in step two that we're talking about now, I'm capturing those ideas into a system and I'm making sure to be able to get them out of my head quickly and easily. So now we move on to part three. Part three is about efficiency. So this is about using templates and systems to be able to be much more scalable and essentially capture things you're already doing as content. As an example, I have a nifty little handheld lavalier recorder by Tascam, and I'll put a link in the description to the one that I actually use. Whenever I give a speaking engagement, what I'll do is I'll actually clip on that little lavalier, and it records directly to a little SD card. So as I'm giving my presentation, I'm actually using a screen recorder to record my presentation that I'm giving to the audience that I'm talking to. Then what I'm able to do is when I get back home, I take the screen recording of the slides that I went through and I'm able to match it up with the audio that I captured on the little Tascam lavalier mic. That's a way that I can very efficiently, in doing something I'm already doing, giving a speaking engagement, I'm able to actually capture that information and reuse it in a way that becomes content for my audience. You can do this in all areas of your life. Let's say you're having a client meeting. As long as you get their permission to record it, you can then use that recording and take some of the information out of that and turn it into, say, a blog post or a case study, things like that. So always look for ways to repurpose things that you're already doing and turn it into new content. Another thing you might want to consider doing along those same lines is using a screen recording app like Loom, or even just the one that's baked in on your Mac computer if you're a Windows computer user. I'm not exactly sure what to tell you to do there, but I'm sure there's screen recording software like Camtasia or any number of other ones. And what you can do is, if you are going to be training one of your employees or teammates or even showing something to your manager, you can actually record yourself giving that presentation of explaining what is the thing that you're working on, why are you working on it, how's it going, whatever the training is, and you can then repurpose that potentially into content later. So the point being is, like, start to think about the tools you can use to capture things that you're already doing and turn that into something else. Now, the second part of this efficiency idea is that you need to be thinking in terms of templates. Templates are a way that you can recreate some of the same ideas over and over. So if it's something that you do time and time again, it's important to set up a template for yourself. So every episode of Shareable, what I do is I right inside Notion, I have a template that's set up and I click new template, and that new interview template is going to give me all of the show notes that I would typically use in an episode of Shareable, including how long it is, subscribe links, placeholders for linking to the guests' social media and their website, and then all of the links to connect with me on social media and anything that I'm looking to promote. So instead of having to go through and consistently create this over and over or find somewhere else and copy and paste, I've just got a template right set up inside Notion. Other ways you can do this are using another tool that I've spoken about in the past called Text Expander, where you create little shortcuts and that allows you to create templates for some of the things you might say over and over. Or let's say when you're promoting on YouTube, you have a certain set of things that you always want to come after the description of your video. Like on the Superhero Institute, you'll notice we always have the links to our different social media sites, places where you can connect with me, etc. So using templates is a way that you're able to give yourself some scalability to work that you would otherwise have to do over and over and over. And when you're looking at creating an immense amount of content, every minute that you save really counts. So look to create templates, look to use reusable assets, look to make sure that your system is consistently evolving and growing and becoming more efficient over time by using templates and by using systems where you're capturing content where you would otherwise not be capturing it, and you would think to yourself about recreating that whole idea. Just capture it in the first place and it'll save you a lot of time. Part four is pretty much where everything comes together. So in part one, we figured out who we are and what we're all about and why we're creating content. And we use that to inform what we're doing in part two of creating a giant list of topics that speak to that audience and deliver that sort of value that you're promising. And you have a system now to capture all of those ideas efficiently and easily into that system that you're able to process and work on that content and get it out the door quickly and easily. And in step three, you're using efficient systems yet again to be able to make sure that as you create that content, you're doing it as efficiently as possible with reusable assets and anything that you do more than once, that you have a system to be able to make that happen quickly. And you're also making sure that the work that you're doing out in the world anyway, that you're trying to capture that and record that and then use that as the basis for creating new and interesting content. And in the fourth part is where we talk about getting that out into the world, and that's distribution. Because if you create a ton of content, it does not matter if no one sees it. So you really want to be efficient and smart about how you go about distributing your content. So there are really about three or four different things that I would recommend, but let me give you some of the high-level ideas here. One is that you should always be looking for opportunities to automatically distribute content. So there's a couple ways that I would suggest doing that. So one of the applications that I use is called Deliverit. And what it does is allows you to fill in RSS feeds from blogs or podcasts or things that you use. And I believe they even have opportunities for you to plug in YouTube channels and different things like that. And then you connect your various social accounts. And when any sort of content goes live, it will pull it right into Deliverit and publish it automatically out onto your social channels. It also has a feature called Echo, where you're able to resend two more times after the initial time that you publish it, sort of like an in case you missed it, or hey, check this out again in case you didn't see it when I first posted it. So what's nice is by setting up that system, you're able to make it that if you, let's say you post a blog post, it'll automatically come in to deliver it. It'll publish it out onto your Facebook, your Twitter, and your LinkedIn. And then a few days later, it'll publish it again and say, hey, in case you missed it, check this out. And then you can set it up for another day later or an hour later. It's up to you. Hey, check this out in case you didn't see it the first time I posted it. So you now have three different opportunities for somebody to actually see that content. And it's all happening automatically in the background. I think systems like this are really helpful because while I think uploading things manually to sites like Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn and all the other places that you can has an incredible amount of value as these networks favor organic distribution, native content. So when you upload a video natively to LinkedIn, it'll do better than posting a YouTube clip, for instance. And there's a lot of value there. There is also a lot of value in the time saving that you get to just get that content out there so that you don't otherwise forget it. Because a lot of times what's going to happen is you'll create this content. It takes a lot of time to create a podcast or a video or a blog post, and you get done with it and you're drained and you're like, all right, I'll just post it on Twitter. And you're done when realistically there's all of these other networks that you're not hitting or you're not hitting again and again and again. So you want to make sure that you have these systems back there supporting you. Now, another system that you can use instead of Deliverit, and I'm sure most of the other social media management software has this, is called Hootsuite. I know probably Sprout Social and any of the other big name social media management softwares have this, but in Hootsuite, you can also plug in an RSS feed and it will automatically send out that content for you onto your different social channels. So a really strong move to do that. But there's other ways that you can actually automatically promote your content. So if you were to start a newsletter, for instance, and you use MailChimp, you can actually plug in an RSS feed into an email campaign and it will pull in the entire content of your blog post or your podcast and send that out as a newsletter to your subscribers. And I strongly recommend you look into the RSS to email option inside of MailChimp if you're a MailChimp user. It can be a great way to make sure that your blog posts are getting automatically sent out to the people on your email list who may really want to see that. So, three different types of automation: Deliverit, Hootsuite, and MailChimp. And then the final point of distribution is that you really need to be thinking about posting your content on your social media channels and getting it out in front of people. And I know that that sounds obvious, but really one of the things that we typically do as content creators, and this is not just me, but this is coming from my work of over a decade working with clients who have been creating content, is that we spend the majority of our time on the content creation, the ideation, the production, and then when it comes time for it to be finished, we just toss it up online and we move on to creating the next piece of content. We really have to shift our distribution from putting, let's say, 80% of our time into content creation and 20% on promotion, to flipping that and putting 80% of our time into the promotion of the content we create and 20% into the distribution. So these are the four steps that I go through and the systems that I use to be able to create an immense amount of content each and every week. But it really starts with being very clear on who you are and what you're about, and then having those strong systems to be able to capture those ideas so that when it comes time to sit down and create that content, you're not just staring at a blank screen with a cursor that's flashing at you. You're able to actually pull from an entire library of different content you've been working on, and then you just have to finish it off. And that makes it a lot easier when it comes time to create that content and get it out there. Then you can focus more of your time on the distribution and the promotion of it and making sure that people actually see the content you're creating. And one last thing not to forget when we talk about distribution is that you cannot forget about the impact that social advertising can have in getting in front of the right audiences and at generally a fairly low cost. And we can talk about that in another video, but I just want to make sure that I mentioned it. This has been another lesson on the Superhero Institute. I hope that you found it valuable. And if you are a content creator or someone who is an aspiring content creator, someone who's going to be creating a lot more videos, a lot more podcasts, a lot more blog posts, whatever it is that you're going to be doing, and if you're going to be implementing the system, please do me a favor, drop a note in the comments about where your blog is, where your YouTube channel is, where your podcast is. I would love to see the people who are watching these videos. I'd love to go and check out your content, see what you're up to, and hopefully get to know you a little bit better. As I'm putting myself out there, I would love to see you put yourself out there. So, with that said, this has been another episode. I hope that you take a moment, if you're not already, to subscribe and click that notification bell. I'll be trying to put out more of these episodes each and every week, hopefully giving you the tools that you need to become a real life superhero. So I will see you next week, and we'll be talking about something entirely different. Not exactly sure what it is yet, but I hope to see you here. Thanks so much.